Hey everyone, I hope everyone's having a safe and good couple days. I know the world's going a little crazy here, but there's always things that we can do at home, so I figured we'd get together and work on some stick handling. So you can probably hear my dog barking upstairs. He will do that quite often. Before we get started, I want to go over, because we might have some new viewers or some younger group or just new to the game, that I want to make sure that they know what I'm talking about. And for the ones that have a little more experience, I'm sorry, this is going to be a review for you. But so we're going to go break down the stick. You have your picks, your shaft, and your blade. When we're stick handling, there's different ways you can hold it, but you can definitely hold towards the bottom of the stick, about an inch and a half above the picks. If you like, that's obviously where we'd be shooting. And so it's good to be able to stick handle from down there as well. You have a longer reach. You can hold the middle of the shaft too. There'll be times that I'll be stick handling up near my heels, or you just want to have a stronger push or hold on the stick. And it also allows you to be able to dig in when we're skating and stick handle at the same time. And it's going to be very rare that we're going to hold up top. It's more when we're skating forward with the puck. So we're only going to focus on holding in the middle or at the bottom of the shaft. Now, with the blade, you're going to have your heel and you're going to have your toe. When I'm stick handling, move a couple of these things. You want your blade, I don't know if you can see it down here, but your blade's going to be flat on your whatever surface you're stick handling on. As you can see, I'm holding the middle of my shaft. So if you have your stick with your toe up or your heel on the bottom there, it's going to be kind of difficult to stick handle. So you want to make sure your blade is flush to the surface. And whatever your stick handling, I have a golf ball here at the moment. I'm going to be putting that in the middle of my blade. And I'm going to be back and forth. So it's not going to be choppy and it's not going to be straight and stiff. You want to be able to have some movement in your wrist, and just being able to have, it's called soft hands. So you're going to be able to push back and forth. In the middle of your blade. And that's essentially now. We're going to have different ones that I'll make sure I mention and describe as we go, but essentially, you want it in the middle of your blade, protect, and that's your strongest point to protect the puck or the ball. So, I do have three different kinds of balls here as well. I have a tennis ball. It's a little softer. It's easier on your neighbors if you have an apartment or family in your house. It's nice and quiet. It's also soft to control, so then it's light, so you can do different things. I do have a weighted stick handling ball, which I use most often. It's quite loud, but at the same time, it does train your wrist. It's a little heavier. It's supposed to be the same weight as a puck, but to me, at times, it feels a little heavier. And then a golf ball. So the reason I have the golf ball, it's smaller. It's a little bit slippery on a blade, and it's harder to control. So we're going to start with the lighter one just to get our wrist going. Let's see if I can get these to stay somewhere. Okay, so we're going to go with our right hand. It's most people's dominant hand, so I apologize if this is not, but right hand, middle of the shaft, leaning forward in everything we do with this sport. So we want to make sure we're leaning forward, and if you can get your ball up near your heels. Now, my plexiboard literally ends right where my heels are, so I'm going to be putting it a little bit further back, but in that range, because you want to be leaning forward. We're going to go right hand for a minute. 5 seconds or so, we're going to switch to our left hand. So we'll just transfer it underneath. You can look away and just go on feel, whatever makes it most challenging for you. Try to amuse yourself with something in your house, I guess. Seconds left, and I'm going to switch back to my right hand, and we're going to work on the toe drag. So a toe drag is, I mentioned before, we have the heel and the toe, so the toe of the blade is going to go over top of the, where you have a ball, so over top of our ball, just like this, and you're going to end up pulling it back to where on your back hip, if you can manage that. My dog doesn't like my form, so he's barking again. So we got right back. It's a little tough with the tennis ball, but the motion is what we're trying. You're trying to snap it back. If you don't like that one, the golf ball is a good one to use, just because you can snap it back. All right. So we'll work on that for a little bit. We'll go with our right hand, so you can definitely turn if you want to make it easier. We'll go for a minute. Here we go. We're going to our left hand now, folks. So we'll turn it around. All right, here we go. One more minute. All right, get yourself situated back to where you need to be. That's a good burner. That's two minutes each hand of different motions, and we got more to go. But give those hands a shake. Just your forearms, if you haven't done it in a while or you're new at it, you might need a little rest. We're going to keep going. We've got figure eight around a stick. Now, I have two different sticks that I'm going to show you, depending on the level that you're at. So we have just a flat... shaft, just falling over here, guys. Flat shaft here that that we've cut down, and we can use that. And we also have one that has two pucks drilled into it, so it raises it up, and then we can practice going over and under and different motions that way. So we'll be definitely trying to show you both. If I can find a decent spot, should turn these boards around. So the first one, actually the figure eight, which you're not going to really, you can do a figure eight with this flat stick, but there's different ones you can do. So if the figure eight doesn't, I'll show you, try to show you the figure eight in a second, but realistically you're going to try to use whatever bowl you want and go around. We can practice just going around the stick if that's the level that you're at, but so you'd go up, drag it back, around, toe drag, push it up, back around, and you can go either way. You can also, this is a little trickier, the figure eight, so you can go either way you want, but if I'm bringing it back around toe drag, you're going to pop it over, and then you're going to come back around. So if I'm bringing it around, right here, over, alright, so then you'd be making a figure eight and just working on those hands. We're going to do that for a minute. I'm going to move up, we might just take a time out here because I'm hitting my picks against the wall, so. So that's a bit better. Thank you very much. Okay. If we can see, the other stick has the two pucks. It's a little more challenging. I mean, yes, you can just go underneath, and that makes it easier, but it's the one that you go over top. It's a tire up. So you gotta be able to, you can go anywhere which way. Back is really hard to do. We got that back. So I'm going to use the golf ball still. I'm going to go with my right hand first. It's my dominant hand. And I will challenge myself with the stick that's raised. Ready, guys? Here we go. Alright, we got 1 minute and we're going to go to our left hands. I'm going to use the stick that's flat on our surface here. Yeah, just because I'm a left handed, but we're going to give this a go. I'm still going to try to challenge myself to go over top, but at the same, it's just not as high until I get there. So, alright, so we go around, here we go. Thank you. All right, that's a minute. That was a struggle. But one of the things that you always have to stay encouraged and just keep working no matter what happens. Obviously, that was painful to watch and to do as well, but a couple minutes each day and it will drastically improve. So stay patient and you'll be doing it just like your right hand in no time. The next one is kind of what we've already been doing. It's a forehand backhand over the stick. And if you really, really want, because we've been working on that, we can go a little bit further. Now, this is where I can actually use my tennis ball, just because it doesn't bounce as high. It's a little easier to control. So you can go underneath, you can go over, try to control it. We can do different things. You can still use the stick. Now, it's not going to go onto this stick, but you can still go over top. It gives you a little more freedom. So you can I'll give you the choice, either going over the stick and practicing or over your legs. Going over your legs, you're going to put one stick on a slight of a slant. You push it under, and it's more just a timing drill. So once it hits the bottom of that blade, you're just going to lightly lift it. It should go over top, and then it comes down to your hand-eye accuracy, just on like just being able to stop it and have it not bounce away. So hopefully you're not in a too large of a room. Your duck. So, all right, here we go. Minute. We're gonna have one more thing to do. Let me see if I can move this. Protect those blades a bit. And we're gonna work on free choice here. So we're gonna be able to do. Sorry, I'm being instructed here. Patrick Kane moves. Patrick Kane moves.
Yeah.
I don't know if I have the silky mitts like Patrick Kane, but I will do my best to see what we can come up with here. We're going to need a lot of pucks to do his moves. I don't know if you've ever seen his YouTube video where he stick handles in and out of pucks. That's a fun one to do on the ice. But we'll see what we can do. This is where a free choice. You can do whatever you want with all the tools that we've just went over. And be creative and have fun with it. And as you can see, I've made many mistakes throughout this entire video, so it's okay to make these mistakes. It's the only way to get better is continue to push yourself. So for the next little minute or so, we're gonna have some fun and push. You ready? Here we go. and take a break. Good work from there. I hope everyone had some fun. You can continue stick handling if you want, but that's kind of the routine that I normally go through. As you can see, I have a lot of fun with my right hand, but I'm still working on that left, so don't get frustrated. I know I've had emails in the past of how people, they're not very patient, but it doesn't take long. You just have to keep going with it, and I honestly promote TV or just need a study break if you're at school. If we're doing homework, just take that time. It doesn't take long, and you'll be amazed on how fast you improve and how much you improve, and it's something that you should have fun with. So I hope everyone stays safe and keeps busy. You're going to have a lot of time to stick handle. So thanks for coming in.